कैसे हो मेरे पढ़ाकू? ठीक, बढ़िया। लास्ट टाइम हमने कुछ न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व किए थे, आज हम पढ़ने वाले हैं बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग डिवाइस, दैट इज सॉलेनोइड। कुछ कुछ आपने स्टैंडर्ड 10 में सॉलेनोइड के बारे में पढ़ा होगा, आज हम डिटेल में पढ़ने वाले हैं सॉलेनोइड के बारे में। बट इन आवर सिलेबस वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट लॉन्ग सॉलेनोइड ओनली। हम डिटेल में लॉन्ग सॉलेनोइड के बारे में पढ़ेंगे, शॉर्ट सॉलेनोइड के बारे में हम पढ़ने वाले नहीं। थोड़ा बहुत डिस्कस करेंगे शॉर्ट सॉलेनोइड के बारे में, बाकी डिटेल में हम चर्चा करने वाले हैं लॉन्ग सॉलेनोइड के बारे में। तो आइए स्टार्ट करते हैं टॉपिक सॉलेनोइड। सॉलेनोइड व्हेन वायर इज वुन ऑन एनी नॉन कंडक्टिंग सिलिंड्रिकल बेस like this and if turns are very close to each other then that device is called solenoid. When any insulated wire is wound in a cylindrical form and turns are very close to each other then that device is called solenoid. So the solenoid will be like this. On some cylindrical base this type of wire is wound and distance are very close to each other. Now if length of solenoid is very large in comparison to this radius of cross section if length of the solenoid is very large then that solenoid is called long solenoid. If length of the solenoid is not very large in comparison to radius of cross section then that solenoid is called short solenoid. तो जैसे हमने चैप्टर नंबर 1 में पढ़ा था इनफाइनाइटली लॉन्ग वायर एंड फाइनाइट लेंथ ऑफ वायर, सेम वे हियर दिस इज एक्सट्रीमली लॉन्ग सॉलेनोइड एंड दिस इज शॉर्ट सॉलेनोइड। व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन लॉन्ग सॉलेनोइड एंड शॉर्ट सॉलेनोइड? फर्स्ट लेट मी डिस्कस अबाउट शॉर्ट सॉलेनोइड। पहले शॉर्ट सॉलेनोइड के बारे में डिस्कस कर लेते हैं। व्हेन वी हैव शॉर्ट सॉलेनोइड लाइक दिस, दिस आर द टर्न्स, दिस टर्न्स आई हैव शोन विथ ब्लू कलर लाइन। ये ब्लू कलर की जो लाइन दिख रही है दिस इंडिकेट्स टर्न्स ऑफ द वायर एंड व्हेन वी कनेक्ट दिस वायर विथ सम बैटरी देन व्हाट विल हैपन, करंट विल फ्लो थ्रू दिस वायर एंड हियर यू कैन सी द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। दिस एरोस इंडिकेट्स डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। You can think of solenoid like this. This way wire is wound on a cylindrical base and two ends of the wires are connected with battery. From the positive terminal of the battery current will flow. Current flows from higher potential to lower potential. So this way current is flowing. Current is flowing like this. So if you want the direction of magnetic field then we should apply right hand thumb rule. Using right hand thumb rule easily we can find the direction of magnetic field. तो magnetic field की direction चाहिए तो सीधा क्या लगा दो, right hand thumb rule. So how can we apply right hand thumb rule? Just you have to curl your fingers in the direction of electric current. Electric current is flowing like this and thumb is in this direction. Fingers are in the direction of electric current and thumb will give you the direction of magnetic field. Current is flowing like this. So just you have to hold this solenoid in your right hand palm such that fingers should give the direction of electric current and thumb will give you the direction of magnetic field. Current is flowing like this. current is flowing like this. So using right hand thumb rule, we can find the direction of magnetic field. So magnetic field is in this direction. When we have short solenoid, at that time we will get this type of closed magnetic field lines at the edge of this solenoid. मतलब यहाँ पे हम लोगों को क्लोज मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस मिलने वाली हैं। Here if you consider any point P inside the solenoid, then you can see these magnetic field lines are parallel to each other and they are in the same direction. So at point P you will get uniform magnetic field. But if you consider point Q outside the solenoid, inside the solenoid at point P we will get uniform magnetic field. Outside the solenoid at point Q, as you move away from the solenoid, then strength of magnetic field goes on decreasing. So here you will get a weak magnetic field. Here magnetic field lines are very close to each other, therefore here you will get strong magnetic field. Outside the solenoid you will get weak magnetic field. Because here you can see these magnetic field lines are quite separated and here magnetic field lines are very close to each other. Here inside the solenoid we will have uniform magnetic field lines and outside the solenoid we will get this type of closed loop. As you move away from the solenoid, magnetic field goes on decreasing. This is for short solenoid. But what happens when we consider long solenoid? When length of the solenoid is very large in comparison to radius of cross section, then the solenoid can be treated as long solenoid. In long solenoid we will get magnetic field only inside the solenoid, not outside the solenoid. When we have long solenoid, at that time we will get magnetic field inside the solenoid only, not outside. It is practically observed that when we consider long solenoid, at the time magnetic field outside the solenoid is zero. So we will not get any magnetic field line outside the solenoid. मतलब बाहर कोई magnetic field मिलने वाली नहीं है जब बड़ा solenoid लिया है. Okay. So we will get only magnetic field lines inside the solenoid and inside the solenoid we will get uniform magnetic field. So tell me, here I have shown the direction of electric current, right? You can think of battery like this. Current will flow from higher potential to lower potential. So when current is flowing through these tons of the solenoid, then what will happen? We know that moving charges and electric current, these are the sources of magnetic field. So due to current flowing through this tons, we will get some magnetic field. So how can we find the direction of magnetic field? कैसे find करें magnetic field की direction? Just you have to curl your fingers in the direction of electric current, in the direction of electric current, and thumb will give you the direction of magnetic field. So magnetic field will be in this direction. Yes, sir. मैग्नेटिक फील्ड कौन सी डायरेक्शन में होगी? इस तरह. अगर डायरेक्शन बदल जाए तो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड की भी डायरेक्शन बदल जाएगी. सो हियर वी शुड अप्लाई दिस राइट हैंड रूल प्रॉपरली. अगर प्रॉपरली लगाया जाए तो आप लोगों को इजीली डायरेक्शन मिल जाएगी. अगर गलती कर गए तो डायरेक्शन में गड़बड़ी हो गई. और डायरेक्शन में गड़बड़ी हो गई तो फिर जो इक्वेशन लाने हैं उसमें भी आगे गड़बड़ी हो सकती. तो राइट हैंड रूल लगाने अब आना चाहिए. क्या बात है राइट हैंड रूल लगाना? यस और नो? सो हियर वी विल गेट द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बी वेक्टर. सो व्हेन वी आर हैविंग लॉन्ग सोलेनोइड, एट द टाइम वी विल गेट यूनिफॉर्म मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ओनली इनसाइड द सोलेनोइड. आउटसाइड द सोलेनोइड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड दैट इज जीरो. मतलब बाहर कोई मैग्नेटिक फील्ड मिलने वाली नहीं. तो लॉन्ग सोलेनोइड लेंगे तो हमें मैग्नेटिक फील्ड सिर्फ अंदर मिलेगी, और कैसी मैग्नेटिक फील्ड मिलने वाली है? यूनिफॉर्म मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। इज इट क्लियर टू यू? एकदम परफेक्ट। व्हेन वी हैव शॉर्ट सोलेनोइड एट ए टाइम वी विल गेट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस लाइक दिस। हियर दिस सेम टाइप ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस वी विल गेट ड्यू टू बार मैग्नेट, and about that we are going to study in chapter number 5. Solenoid behave as a bar magnet, that we will prove but in next chapter, chapter number 5. अभी सिर्फ आपको जानकारी दे दी कि next chapter में क्या होगा। this solenoid behave as a bar magnet, this magnetic field lines, same magnetic field lines we will get for bar magnet. तो आज solenoid के बारे में पढ़ लेते हैं, bar magnet के बारे में next chapter. Due to this long solenoid only we will get magnetic field lines inside the solenoid. Now I want to find the magnetic field due to this long solenoid. What is the value of magnetic field due to this long solenoid? The solenoid ki wajah se kitni magnetic field hame milne wali hai wo find karna hai. To kaise find kiye? If you want to find easily the magnetic field due to this current carrying wires, then we should apply Ampere's circuital law. And whenever we want to apply Ampere's circuital law, at the time first of all we should consider one Amperean loop. Here you can see these terms are very close to each other. Whenever we consider distance to be very close to each other, at that time we will get this type of uniform magnetic field. So whenever we are considering solenoid, at the time distance should be very close to each other. Here if we take this much length of the solenoid and if we count the number of turns in this much length of solenoid, then number of turns per unit length, number of turns per unit length is denoted by small n. So small n is called number of turns per unit length. For this total length L, suppose there are capital N number of turns. कितने टर्न मान लिए? कैपिटल एन। तो यहाँ पे स्मॉल एन क्या हो जाएगा? कैपिटल एन बाय एफ। टोटल नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स पर यूनिट लेंथ इज कॉल्ड नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स पर यूनिट लेंथ। मान लो कि ये पूरे के टोटल नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स नहीं गिने, इफ दिस टर्न्स आर वेरी क्लोज टू ईच अदर एंड इफ वी मेजर दिस मच नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स एंड दिस मच लेंथ, देन नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स पर यूनिट लेंथ विल बी स्मॉल एन। So this way also we can find number of turns per unit length. Here I have shown cross section of this solenoid. Cross section of the solenoid. This is long solenoid. And this is the cross section of the solenoid. What does this dot indicate? This dot indicates turns coming out from the plane of figure, and this cross indicates turns going in the plane of figure, or you can say this dot indicates current coming out, and here this cross indicates current going in, current coming out, going in, coming out, going in, coming out, going in. This way you can see current coming out, going in, coming out, going in. We have taken just cross section of the solenoid. This is the cross section. यहाँ से बीच में से थोड़ा जाए तो कुछ ऐसा दिखेगा, turns coming out, going in, turns coming out, going in. And here I have considered very long solenoid. So due to long solenoid we will have uniform magnetic field. So we will get uniform magnetic field. therefore I have shown this magnetic field lines parallel to each other. Yes or no? These magnetic field lines are parallel to each other. Now, if I want to find magnetic field due to this solenoid, then we can find this magnetic field using Ampere's circuit law very easily. So to apply Ampere's circuit law, first of all we should consider one planar loop that is called Ampere's loop. Right now I am considering this rectangular loop. What I am considering? Rectangular loop. Half of the rectangular loop is outside the solenoid and half of the rectangular loop is inside the solenoid. आधा लूप बाहर है, आधा लूप अंदर है। अब ध्यान से देखो कैसे मैग्नेटिक फील्ड निकालते हैं यूजिंग एम्पियर सर्किट। लेट मी टेक दिस पॉइंट टू बी ए बी सी डी एंड दिस आई एम टेकिंग द डायरेक्शन ऑफ लेफ्ट। इन दिस डायरेक्शन वी विल टेक लाइन एलिमेंट। नाउ टोटल लेंथ of this rectangular loop I am taking f, length kya lete hain f, okay, for this Ampere's loop if we apply Ampere's circuit law, then what is Ampere's circuit law? Closed loop line integration of magnetic field is equal to product of permeability of a free space and algebraic sum of electric currents enclosed by this Ampere's loop. So here we can write IE or I enclosed, total amount of current enclosed. Like Gauss's law we can write I enclosed. In Gauss's law we have written closed loop surface integration of electric field is charge enclosed upon epsilon naught. Yes sir. Here closed loop line integration of magnetic field is the product of permeability of free space and total electric current enclosed by the Ampere's loop. Here this closed loop integration can be written as, for this Ampere's loop we can write this as B vector dot dl vector start from A A to B then B to C then C to D. Then D to A is equal to mu naught I E. Yes sir. क्या ठीक? आइए देख लेते हैं. Integration A to B, B vector dot dl vector as it is, plus B vector dot dl vector for this part B to C. Here you can see, if we consider any line element from B to C, then that line element will be perpendicular to magnetic field B vector. Yes sir. Both are perpendicular to each other, and whenever we remove dot, at the time cos B D L cos theta, and here theta will be 90 degree. When line element and magnetic field both are perpendicular to each other, at the time this integration comes out to be zero. Yes sir. So here we will get zero for this much part which is inside the solenoid. For that B vector dot dl vector is zero, and for the part which is outside the solenoid, for that magnetic field is zero. Therefore integration B vector dot dl vector from B to C we will get zero. Chalo kaam aaj C to D. डी, बी वेक्टर डॉट डी एल वेक्टर, सी टू डी, दिस मच पोर्शन ऑफ द लूप इज आउटसाइड द सॉलिड एंड फॉर दैट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज जीरो, जीरो इंटू एनीथिंग, सो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड दैट इज जीरो, जीरो इंटू एनीथिंग जीरो, कहां पहुंचे डी, डी टू ए, वंस अगेन डी टू ए दैट इज इन डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज इन दिस डायरेक्शन, वंस अगेन बोथ आर परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर, when both are perpendicular to each other at the time this integration b vector dot dl vector will be 0 is equal to mu not I e, because b vector, because b is equal to 0 or b vector is perpendicular to dl vector, we are getting 0 because b is equal to 0 or b vector is perpendicular to डीएल। इस पोर्शन के लिए मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जीरो, इसलिए इंटीग्रेशन क्या बना जीरो। बाकी के पोर्शन के लिए मैग्नेटिक फील्ड दैट इज परपेंडिकुलर टू लाइन एलिमेंट, देयरफॉर वी आर गेटिंग इंटीग्रेशन बी वेक्टर डॉट डीएल वेक्टर जीरो। चलो कौन बचा, ए टू बी, बी वेक्टर डॉट डीएल वेक्टर, देयरफॉर इंटीग्रेशन ए टू बी, हियर बी वेक्टर एंड डीएल वेक्टर बोथ आर इन द सेम डायरेक्शन, फॉर दिस line element will be in this direction and magnetic field is also in the same direction and uniform magnetic field will be here, therefore if we remove dot then we can write b d l cos theta, angle between them that is 0 cos 0 that is 1, so integration a to b b d l mu not I e, yes sir, what is I e, that is the amount of current enclosed by this loop, क्या ठीक, इंटीग्रेशन ए टू बी बी डी एल इज इक्वल टू मी नॉट आई ई, व्हाट इज आई ई, दैट इज द करंट एनक्लोज्ड बाय दिस एम्पिरियन लूप, याद करो स्मॉल एन क्या लिया था मैंने आगे, दैट इज नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स पर यूनिट लेंथ, सो पर यूनिट लेंथ नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स आर एन, देन फॉर लेंथ एल नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स विल बी एन इनटू एल, अमाउंट ऑफ करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू ईच टर्न That is I. एक टर्न में से कितना करंट फ्लो है? I. So number of turns enclosed by this empyrean loop are NL. So total current enclosed by this empyrean loop that is NLI. ध्यान से देखो. What is small n? That is number of turns per unit length. So for unit length number of turns are N. So for L length number of turns will be N into L. Current flowing through each turn, that is I. So total current flowing through this empyrean loop, that is N L I. Yes sir. So current enclosed by this empyrean loop, that is nothing but N L I. So this can be written as magnetic field that is uniform. So we can take it outside integration. Integration A to B D L. Is equal to mu naught into N L I. What is the integration A to B D L? That is the summation of all the line elements on this path A to B. That is nothing but total length of this much portion of the loop. What is the total length of A B? That is nothing but L. So we can write. Therefore, B into L is equal to mu naught N L I. This L L will get cancelled. Therefore, magnetic field B is equal to mu naught N I. This is the formula of magnetic field. Magnetic field due to long solenoid is mu naught N I. What is mu naught? That is permeability of free space. What is small n? Number of turns per unit length. What is I? That is the amount of electric current flowing through each turn of the solenoid. Is it clear? So magnetic field due to long solenoid is mu naught N I. When long solenoid is given, at that time we can use this formula of magnetic field. क्या समझ में आया? एकदम clear, perfect. जब भी एम्पिरियन लूप लगाना है क्या कर लो, एक प्लेनर लूप कंसीडर कर लो, then we can apply ampere circuit law. Closed loop line integration of magnetic field is nothing but product of permeability of free space and amount of current enclosed by the loop. Here I have considered rectangular loop. Rectangular loop के लिए लगा देंगे छोटे छोटे portion में इस closed loop को divide कर देते हैं a to b, b to c, c to d, d to a. Line integration of magnetic field for b to c, c to d and d to a, that is zero. Because outside the solenoid magnetic field is zero and for this part d to c and d to a magnetic field is perpendicular to line element, therefore we will get line integration of magnetic field zero. IE, that is the current enclosed by the loop, current flowing through each turn, that is I, therefore current flowing through this much turn of the loop, that is MLI, where small l, that is number of turns per unit length. So integration ddl a to b is nothing but mu naught ie. Magnetic field that is uniform, therefore we can take it outside the integration a to b dl mu naught nli. Integration a to b dl, that is nothing but total length of this much part of the loop a to b, and that is nothing but l. So b into l is equal to mu naught nli. L and L will get cancelled, so magnetic field B is equal to mu naught Ni. This way we can obtain the formula of magnetic field due to solenoid. Important theory of this chapter, they can ask you like this: obtain the formula of magnetic field due to long solenoid. So this formula you have to obtain. I hope the concept of solenoid is now clear to you. Next time we will study about toroid. आज हमने सोलेनोइड के बारे में पढ़ा है, नेक्स्ट टाइम हम पढ़ेंगे टोरॉइड के बारे में. विद दिस आई एम एंडिंग टुडेस लेक्चर. मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में, तब तक के लिए बाय बाय, थैंक यू.